Ah, hello and welcome to Tensar Ground Coffee. A few minutes on ground engineering to enjoy it while having your coffee. Well, I know what it looks like. It looks like I'm playing cards at home on my own. I was actually explaining an important principle of pavement engineering to my children, but they seem to have wandered off. I can't explain why. Anyway, that gives me an opportunity to talk to you about pavement engineering. Now, you're probably quite familiar with installing geogrids, such as Tensar geogrids, for pavements for subgrade stabilisation. So that's where the subgrade is weaker than you expect, or is weaker than in other areas, and you want a bit of help to stabilise that, to improve the load spread through the granular layers down to the subgrade, so that the pavement achieves satisfactory performance. But what if I told you that even on competent subgrades, if you place a geogrid within the unbound granular layer, you get much less deformation and wear and tear of that granular layer, which translate into an improved performance at the surface, on the paved surface. And not only that, that we have design methods for that as well. So if I told you that, you'd certainly be interested, I think, but quite rightly you'd probably say, well, where's your validation? So what we do have some case studies. So that's where we've installed Tensar geogrids into real roads on a site, and we have looked at the performance. But the disadvantage with that is that there are many variables out of your control. So imagine that we installed some geogrid within the unbound granular layer to this road along here. Now, we could monitor the performance over time, look at rutting and cracking in the surface and so on over time. So we could get a sort of quantitative assessment of pavement performance, but we wouldn't really get hard data or something that we could put into a design method, because there are just so many variables in this situation. So you've got the subgrade for a start. That could vary quite easily along the length of the road. So you would get better performance in some areas than others just because of the subgrade. Also, during construction, the unbound layers and the bound layers could have slightly different materials, different construction methods as we go along the road. And then during service, we have different environmental factors. The temperature can vary, so that affects particularly the asphalt performance. And then you can get moisture changes. They will affect particularly the unbound layers and the subgrade performance as well. And you can even get giant lizards on your site as well. So, you know, anything can happen, things that you don't have control of. Something else is the loading. So look at all these vehicles we have here. So all the different vehicles that could be using the road, all applying different wheel loads, different tire sizes, different tire pressures. They might be in slightly different positions along the road. Something that's very difficult to monitor, to measure during service. So we've got all those variables that make it very difficult to get hard data to derive and to validate a design method and a performance of an improvement like a geogrid. So pavement engineering bodies, they recommend accelerated pavement testing, APT. That's where you perform full-scale testing, but in a dedicated test facility where you can control all of these variables rather than on a real road out on site. Full-scale APT will be performed at dedicated testing facilities. So during construction, the variables are much more controlled. So the subgrade would be prepared in a consistent way, so you'd have the same subgrade characteristics and strength across all the test sections that are constructed there. And then when the pavement is constructed, the unbound granular layers and then the pavement layers, the bound pavement layers, they will have consistent materials, consistent construction methods throughout. So there's no variable not much variation in the construction. You also have the advantage that you can install a lot of instrumentation during construction, more than you can on a real site, because you're on a dedicated test site. So you can be measuring the performance of all those layers during your trial. Usually these facilities, or ideally these facilities, are undercover, so you're helping to remove some of the effects of weather conditions, and you can remove that variation of moisture due to rainfall. The better facilities are also climate controlled, so that there's no variation in temperature either. So that's eliminated a lot of the variables, but what about the loading? You can choose to drive real trucks over your test section, but that's going to be a lot of passes of trucks for some poor driver to do all of those. There may be a little bit of wander in an uncontrolled fashion rather than in a controlled fashion. So to overcome that issue, APT tends to be performed with heavy vehicle simulators, HVS. Now, to help show you what they look like, my kids and I, we constructed out of Meccano our very own HVS. So get in there nice and close, Brian, to have a look at this. You know the old adage that budding architects play with Lego while budding engineers play with Meccano. So we use Meccano to construct our own HVS. So they can be moved around a little bit to whichever part of a test section that is going to be tested, and then they are parked there, then they stay there for the duration of the test. The top of the range models are all got walls around here for climate control, so they can control the climate conditions during the test. And here we have the actual loading that is applied by this wheel here. So you see here that we've got a dual wheel arrangement. You can have different arrangements constructed, but we've got a dual wheel there, and the loading is controlled. Here we're just using the self-weight, but the real facilities have a way to control the loading. The tyre size is constant, the tyre pressure is monitored and kept constant. Then what happens is that wheel load, which is constant throughout the test, is just moved to and fro over the test section. Some models do have the ability to lift the wheel so that it returns without making contact, so that the loading is in the same direction all the time, or other ones go to and fro like this. Now, of course, this can be automated and left to run for weeks until you accumulate hundreds of thousands or even millions, over a million passes over the section. So that's also eliminated the variable of the traffic loading. So we've got consistent construction conditions, consistent climatic conditions, and a consistent loading. So that's all part of what APT is all about. So then when we introduce geogrid, that is the only variable. So we can have a test section without geogrid and a test section with geogrid, and all other conditions are the same. So we can be very sure about the benefit of the geogrid. What we may choose to do, this is what we often do, is we have a thicker granular layer, an asphalt layer in the control section without geogrid, and then we will do a thinner unbound aggregate layer, and maybe a thinner bound layer as well, to show equivalent or better performance with the geogrid compared without the geogrid, also having savings in construction because of the thinner sections. So at Tensar, we have done precisely this sort of testing to demonstrate the performance of our applications. So in particular, using the US Army Corps of Engineers facility in Vicksburg in the US, actually three series of tests we've performed now on flexible pavements, the most recent one on quite a competent subgrade with a CBR of 6%, to demonstrate that these performance benefits are also very significant even on quite a competent subgrade. This is the phenomenon we're calling pavement optimization. It's not just for soft subgrade areas. You can get a significant increase in performance even when you have a competent subgrade. So in that latest series of testing on a CBR of 6%, by introducing the Tensar geogrid, we got a 44% reduction in surface rutting on the top surface of the pavement, or we got a 20% savings in construction costs for equivalent performance, and also 25% CO2 emission savings during construction compared to the control section. So there you go. Tensar geogrids are one of the few pavement stabilization options that have been through this rigorous validation and testing process of APT. So that's all for this episode of Tensar Ground Coffee. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.